In this video, we're going to solve a circuit where we have a voltage source in the circuit where neither side is ground. This 0.6 volt voltage source right here that you see is not connected to ground on either side, and we haven't solved a circuit like this using node voltage method yet, so we're going to see how to do that. Now notice over on the left I have the same exact circuit because I want to show you two solutions. Okay, so starting over here, you can see that the bottom node is ground, and we have two known nodes, right? This node here has 20 volts with respect to ground because there's just a voltage source connected between those two nodes. And this node here has 5 volts with respect to ground because there's just a 5 volt source connected between this node and ground. So our two unknown nodes we have are right here that I labeled A, B, and I have the currents defined to set up our KCL equations. So one KCL equation at node A is going to be I1 plus 1 milliamp, and I'm going to write that in amps, so 0.001 amps, and that equals IS. Okay, so that's our KCL at node A. At node B, we'll just have that IS is equal to I2. Okay, and then we can just plug that up here, right? That IS equals I2. And then we can take this equation and write each of the currents through the resistors in terms of voltages in Ohm's law. So I1 will get 20 minus VA over 1K. And then we got the 1 milliamp, okay, 0.001. Then that equals I2, which is just VB minus 5. Over 1K. So you see, in a problem like this, once you're done writing your node voltage expression, okay, here's our node voltage expression. Well, look, we've got two unknowns. Okay, one equation, two unknowns. So you see, in order to solve this, we need to come up with another equation that involves VA and VB. Well, this goes back to your understanding of voltage. See, when you have a voltage source connected between two nodes, well, the value of that voltage source tells you the difference in voltage between those two nodes. See, the fact that this voltage source is a 0.6 voltage source, it tells me that VA is 0.6 volts higher than VB, right? Because the higher voltage end of that difference is connected to node A. So there's my second equation. It's just going to be that VA VA minus VB is equal to 0.6 volts. So you see, now I have my two equations, two unknowns, and I can solve for VA and VB. Now, before I give you the answers to VA and VB, I want to show you how you can approach this problem a slightly different way. So over at the right side here, I have the same exact circuit. It's set up the same way, right? Ground's still this bottom node. You can see that, you know, I have my known nodes marked off. Here's I1 flowing through the 1K, I2 flowing through this 1K, and so on. But you see, the difference here is that we're going to use a concept that's called supernode. Okay, supernode. And all the term supernode refers to is when you have this case of a voltage source where neither side is connected to ground. So you see, I put a dash circle around what's called a supernode. Okay, this is our supernode. And when you have a supernode, for the purposes of writing a KCL equation, you can treat that node as a single node. See, over here we treated nodes A and B as two separate nodes when we wrote the KCL, Okay, here we're going to treat the supernode, when we write the KCL equation, as just a single node. Okay, so look what happens. So this is, KCL at supernode. Okay, so we're just treating nodes A and B here as one single node. So all I have is I have I1 flowing into the supernode, and I have the 1 milliamp flowing into the supernode. Okay, and then I2 is the only current flowing out of the supernode. Okay, so now I just write the currents through the resistors in terms of voltage using Ohm's law, just like I did previously, and as you always do when you're doing this method. So 20 minus VA over 1K. Oops. Okay, that's a K. And then I2 is just VB minus 5 over 1K. And you see we're left with the same expression as we got over here. And we're going to need a second expression, and it's the same VA minus VB equal to 0.6 volts. So you see, using this supernode concept, you end up with the same node voltage expression, and also you need the same second expression that you get from the voltage source as we did earlier. So what's the big deal about supernode? Well, it's not really a big deal in my opinion, but supernode will just save you one step. Because see here, when we solve the problem without the supernode, you know, we just had to make this one substitution here. Okay, well, supernode will just save you that. You know, when you have a circuit with just one supernode, whether using it is really all that useful is probably debatable, because again, it just saves you the one step. But in some circuits, if you have multiple supernodes, knowing this can save you quite a bit of work. Okay, but the key point is, and the reason why I chose to show it this way with both solutions side by side, is just to show you that you could solve a circuit like this without even knowing what the supernode concept is. In fact, I remember when I was an undergrad EE student that we never used the supernode. In fact, it wasn't until I started teaching here at Cal Poly that, you know, when I opened up the circuits book that, you know, we use here, I saw the term supernode, and I was kind of like, well, what is that? Never heard of that. And, you know, I looked at it and I said, oh, it's just a way to, you know, save you a little bit of work. Okay, but it's not really that super in my opinion. So in either case, you get the same simultaneous equations to solve. So if you go ahead and solve this, VA will come out to, let's see, 13.3 volts. And that means VB is 0.6 volts less than that. So 12.7 volts. And say we wanted to find I1 from those values, well, we would just plug in. Right, here's our I1 right here, so that's just going to be 20 minus 13.3K, or excuse me, 20 minus 13.3 volts divided by 1K. That will give us an answer of 6.7 milliamps. And then I2, well, we just plug in here, VB is 12.7, so 12.7 minus 5. That's what? That's going to be 7.7? Right, 7.7. So 7.7 milliamps. And do those numbers make sense? Well, if you do a KCL equation right at node A here, you got 1 milliamp flowing in, and you got 6.7 milliamps flowing in, so you better have 7.7 milliamps flowing out, right? So the current I2 that's flowing through this 1K, the 7.7 milliamps, that's the same current through this 0.6 volt source because they're in series, right? They have the same path. Also, it's the same current through the 5 volt, right? Because this is all one path here, these three components. So this 0.6 volt source is absorbing power because the current is entering its higher voltage end, and also this source is absorbing, right? Because current's flowing into the higher voltage end of the 5 volt source. The 20 volt source is supplying power, and this 1 milliamp source is also supplying power, right? Because VA 13.3 volts, so it's 13.3 volts higher, this node, than ground. So these two sources supplying, these two sources absorbing, and to get how many watts supplying absorbing, all you have to do is V times I. Okay, so that's, again, the primary reason for this lecture was to show this concept of the supernode. The next couple of videos, we'll be doing more problems that involve the supernode.